Namaste, Mitron. Welcome back to Movie Community College. Maren, I'm Tish Hay.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It is me, the professor. I hope all is well. How are you doing today?
I hope you're well.
Yes, we have a movie review to do.
We do. We are extraordinarily busy, and so it's been a while since we've been able to watch a movie.
Yeah, we watched a couple of them that we haven't done reviews on yet.
Right. This one is called Shootout at Lokhandwala.
And it had Amitabh Bachchan in it.
It had Amitabh in it, and I really wanted this to be a good movie.
I think it should have been a good movie. I think that to start off with, this film is based on
true events,
mm-hmm. and it's the story of gangs taking over Mumbai to a point that is unbearable,
mm-hmm.
and a task force is kind of commissioned to go about business however they see fit,
right?
Which of course will run them afoul with
the
things
courts,
like policy, procedures,
the law.
Right.
So the movie kind of starts off, the whole movie is really told in flashback type sequences. And so
I felt really bad for Amitabh to be a part
too.
Of this.
I did too. Oh my gosh.
I mean, I'm not going to make fun of the film.
Okay. So first off, before we actually get started with talking what it was about, let me just kind of read to you the cast of characters, all right, uh-huh. the actors. Amitabh, obviously.
Right.
Abhishek had a brief
very
role.
Very small.
Probably one of his very first roles, because this was like a 2007 film. Sanjay Dutt was one of the main characters. Sunil Shetty, one of the main characters. Rohit Roy, one of the main characters. The main bad guy who played...
Rohit Roy was fat, too. I didn't realize
Yes. The guy who played Maya Dolas... It looks like it would be pronounced Vivek, but I bet it's Vivek Oberoi. So there's a decent cast of characters in this film, okay?
Yeah.
Based on true events of Dolas, the bad guy. So this should have been great.
We see this gang being run by David.
Vivek Oberoi. They never mentioned Dawood Ibrahim by name.
Right.
But he's the main bad guy who's
in Dubai.
He's
hiding out in Dubai.
Right.
And he's having a problem with this gang is getting too, they're becoming too rascally.
Right, but you've jumped the gun here. The movie starts off with the reporter outside of Lokhandwala, and she's really upset with what the task force has done because they've gone after these five or six bad guys. But in the meantime, you know, there are lots of innocent people who are kind of caught in the crossfire. Mm. And so there are like hundreds of, you know, casings, thousands of, you know, bullet casings. And so she's broadcasting this event live, basically. And then we kind of fast forward a little bit, like it's a month beyond that, and we see Sanjay Dutt and his two main guys who are part of his task force, and they're sitting there in front of Big B. And we don't realize till the end that Big B is actually kind of their lawyer. And so he's interrogating them about how their task force has operated because he's going to be representing them in front of the judge. Mm-hmm. We don't know that mm-hmm. at this point.
Right.
So
it almost has a flair of like they're being interrogated by Amitabh.
You don't realize it. It almost looks like maybe he is a high-ranking official in the government who is going to be reprimanding and disciplining mm-hmm. them, mm-hmm. but that's not exactly what happens.
No.
So then the rest of the film is basically flashbacks of how this gang came to be, how the task force came to be.
And the flashbacks weren't even in chronological order.
No,
so
it was
you were jumping,
so
like,
jumpy.
It was jumping
so
around.
So choppy. So jumpy. The camera work was not very good with this film.
And let me just say this. You know, as this thing's kind of unfolding and we're hearing the story in flashbacks, it dawns on me, Dutt is playing the guy who's going to be hunting down the gang members.
Dolas. Mm-hmm.
That are being in, they have ties to
Dawood Ibrahim.
Like,
and then,
like, nobody sees anything weird about
that, right?
You know what I mean?
I know.
It's like the neighbors to the west celebrating a Hindustani festival
right,
of
like
love.
That
like,
would be
like
weird.
What?
Right.
What? This is like,
it, okay, there were so
and Dutt, dude, his mom was Nargis. I know. How can you not act, dude? Your mom is the greatest actress in India cinema, and you can't even act your way out of a paper bag, dude. Like, are you kidding
Quite
me?
Quite honestly, his performance in the 2004
He looked like he was on drugs. He looked like he was stoned out of his mind.
His performance in the 2004 DWAR was much better than this performance.
I would sure hope so. Yeah. This thing was terrible. This performance was terrible.
Okay. This should have been a great film because of the events that it's based on.
It should have been one of the best films you've ever seen.
Should have been a blockbuster. The best scenes in the film were the ones with Big B in them. And I'm not just saying that because I love him. You even agreed. Mm. Because the rest of the film was so choppy and so... It was just not put together well.
If Amir Khan had come out and apologized for Gangs of Hindustan Amitabh Bachchan, they should have given him his money back.
Yes, this
Or they should have
paid him
doubled
triple
it.
Or
yes.
something.
This was really bad.
It was so bad. The main bad guy, Dolas, played by Vivek Oberoi, his character very much reminded me of Manoj Vajpayee in Satya.
Yes, very much reminded me
of that same type of character.
You're right. Yes. And he did a great job as the bad guy. He was outstanding in his performance.
Right.
His mom was outstanding.
And
almost had a Goodfellas feel when they were at dinner and the mom
cooking
and
was
all the gangsters. Yes, and she pulled the gun on the guy.
Yes, yeah. Right? She was crazy.
She was crazy.
Yeah, so there were bits and pieces of the film that
she reminded me of your mom.
Maybe in my mom's younger days, not my mom today.
No.
But my mom in her younger days. There were bits and pieces of this film where you're like, wow, that was kind of a bright spot. And boy, if they had filmed it this way the whole time, could have been a good film. This film should be redone.
Yes, this is prime for a remake.
Absolutely.
Dude.
Put Akshay in it. Put Shahid Kapoor. I don't know. Put Vicky Kaushal. Redo this film.
Yes.
It could be so good. I think the main problem was you should never have had Sanjay Dutt in this film.
Dutt looked like he was on...
And then I was pointing out to you, okay, so this movie is 12 years old. And if you look at how old he was at the time, like 48 in real life, and Big B was like, 63 in real life, I was like, they look like they're the same age because Sanjay Dutt was so bad.
Yeah, this should have been a great film. I'm going to end this early because our camera is freezing up, which is a bad sign. And
give it a grade.
A D.
I was going to say C minus. So
I'll give it a D. I'll give it a D.
Not a Bollywood Top 100.
It's whatever the Bollywood Top 100. This would be
it's the opposite.
All right. We'll catch you guys later.
Bye, friends.
Bye.